all the fault codes.
Hello, you absolute legends. Welcome back to the channel. John here. I'm getting my money's worth out of this selfie stick. What do you think to that? It's a rainy day here in Lincolnshire, and I'm back with the Smart 451 Night Orange. Bonus Proton Impian here and Nissan Note, which means that, yes, we're back at Dad's with the car. And if you remember before Christmas now, we had an intermittent EML light on the Night Orange before MOT, which was down, apparently, according to Sam, to a solenoid issue. We took the solenoid out, we cleaned it, and did an oil and filter change. It hasn't solved the problem. The EML light is back on. Well, thankfully, the good people at Kingbolen, who, if you have watched the channel before, they've sent us the big old scanner. They've sent me this, which is the Ediag Elite. Effectively, you plug it into your OBD port and Bluetooth it to your phone. In this video then, we're going to test the Ediag Elite and see what is going wrong with the Smart Night Orange. Hopefully it's the P0012 fault, because we know we've got that. Hopefully it's not something else. Yeah, let's try it. The Kingbolen, what's it called? Ediag Elite. Hello.
Hello, buddy.
Smart 451.
Yes, mate.
Night Orange.
Yes, sir.
It's back with the intermittent EML light. It's come on this morning as I've filled up with petrol. It's been on and off. Yeah, I know. It's been on and off. So it's been coming on in stop-start traffic. It's then been going off. It's
Are you sure you're not just making it go on and off for content?
For content? No, sadly not. We normally use the Kingbolen scanner, the S800, which does the job, but we've been sent a new thing to try out. Stop putting your nice shiny tools away and have a look at this. What do you think to that?
So you ain't got to use the Kingbolen?
Well, no. Effectively, your phone is the Kingbolen. are you that shocked that it's made your ear flaps come up? Oh, now who's on the phone? It's the Prime Minister of Malaysia.
No, it's not.
He's heard you saying bad things about protons this week.
Hello?
Who's on the phone? Ah, scam?
Probably. You've dialed an incorrect number.
You've called them back, dialed an incorrect number.
Do you think that was a scam?
Sounds like a scam to me.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. Anyway, let's talk about the Kingbolen, which hopefully is not a scam. The Ediag Elite. Let's get it out of the box and have a look. Right, so in the box, let's take a look and open this up. Oh, look at that. That's a nice little thing. You've got a little pouch there and the instructions. Scan to activate device. I probably shouldn't show you this, but oh, well, it doesn't matter. Right, Bluetooth diagnostic tool. Let's have a look. Oh, shiny. Okay, so in the box, you get this in the little pouch. Bluetooth vehicle diagnostic tool, quick start menu. Got to I've got to download an app. I don't like that. Scan the QR code, download the app, log in, activate your device, Bluetooth connection, and start using it. Okay, well, I'm not going to do that on my mobile phone. I'm going to use a burner phone. So I've got my burner phone, which is actually my old phone, and all I've done is just connect it to the Wi-Fi. Look how beautiful Mrs. John Coupland is, by the way. Right, now we need to do a QR scan. Right, let's do the QR scan. Scan QR code. It's found that. So it's taken me to a Google Play to download Ediag. Suggested for you, KFC. Yes, sounds good to me. So it's 76.97 megabytes. And now it's installing. So now I've opened the app. I've got this, which is pretty much the screen that you see on the Kingbolen that we normally use. So apparently I've got to sign up. Ah. Please enter email or password or log in with verification code. Okay, so it verifies it to your... Right, here you go. So let's register for a new account. A verification code has been sent to your email. Oh, that's good, isn't it? Here it is. Here's my verification code. Please enter a new username. I don't like the fact that I'm having to do this. So now I'm signed in. Now what do I do? activate it. Click on the activate button in the EDIAG app. Ah, so now we can scan the QR code. Here we go. So now we can scan the activation code. There it is. An error occurred with the server. That's a good start, isn't it? Failed to activate. Do not relax and try again. This isn't very good. Ah, here we go. Congratulations. Relaxed and try again. Please visit store in 1 minute. Binding successfully. Please visit store in 1 minute. Pull to refresh this page. Oh. How to install. Oh, we've got all the... No Proton there, look. Found it at A, yeah. The installation is successful. Is it? Is it successful? Bluetooth connection. Oh, so now it's looking for the device. I suppose we better go and plug it in. Of course the EML has gone out. See, I told you it was intermittent. It's shy. Every time I try and get a video of the EML light on this car, it disappears. Anyway, this morning, the EML light was on. And the OBD socket is down there. So let's open that up and plug in the Kingbolen. Oh, it's in and it's gone green. So I've shut the door because it's thankfully raining outside. Let's get the old burner phone out. There's Crystal, look, living the dream. Go on to there. Scanning for Bluetooth. Couldn't pair. Oh dear. Let's try again. Let's go into the actual Bluetooth menu. Paired. So I'm paired with the Kingbolen now. Bluetooth connection failed. Please confirm. Oh, now I'm connected. Here we go. I think. Bluetooth connected. So now I'm connected up here. It's a bit fiddly. It's a bit more fiddly than the usual. Plug in your diagnostic tool and away you go. But I've turned the car on. I've got the ignition on. Right. All systems diagnostics then, please. VIN scan. Oh, select make. Smart. Well, now it's downloading a software update. Well, this isn't as intuitive as I'd expected. This is taking a long time. Right, good. That's installed now. It's taken about 5 minutes to do that. Failed to load data. That's good, isn't it? This is terrible. Bluetooth connected. All systems diagnostic. Yeah, I know about that. Don't tell me about that again, thank you. VIN scan. Smart. Do you have to be connected to the internet to do this then, all the time? The car's making some funny... the thing's making some funny beeping noises. Now is reading the information of the car. Oh, yeah, I think so. What are we left? We're right-hand drive. Let's do a health report. Oh dear, it's found lots of fault codes. Oh dear. All the fault codes. Well then, this is interesting, isn't it? It's found... Ah. It's got some stored codes. P12, which we were expecting. This one. Adjustment of the intake camshaft cylinder bank 1 is performed late. Right, well, we knew about that. Let's clear those fault codes. Let's read these SAM codes. Batteries in key are empty or wrongly inserted. Well, I know about that actually, because I've just done that. Left turn signal lamp defective. Right turn signal lamp defective. Did it tell me a date on then? Well, I think they are okay, so let's clear them. Well, it's interesting, if anything. Still telling me I've got a engine code. Ignore fault code. Instrument cluster. What's that then? Implausible signals from steering wheel gear shift. Ah. Let's clear that as well, because I've not got a problem with the steering wheel gear shift. Let's clear all the system codes. It's telling me to switch off the ignition. Let's do that. Switch on the ignition. And in theory, well, I've got no fault codes. That's reading that. Well, it's done its job, hasn't it? But it's actually found more than the previous Kingbolen. Really quit. Got all sorts of other functions on here. Maintenance functions, oil maintenance reset, immobilizer reset, ABS bleeding, etc, etc. I'm not going to mess about with any of that. Let's take some more software updates. Oh, there we are. Mill status off. Good, good. Well, it works. Right, so I've done the diagnostic on the smart... Can you hear me through your flaps? I've done the diagnostic on the Smart 451. We've got the P12 problem again. What's the plan with regards to that?
Follow diagnosis, mate, so it's a new solenoid.
Did you get the solenoid part number?
No.
No, neither did I. So new solenoid required for the Smart 451.
That's what it says, mate.
And hopefully that fixes the problem. Why would it be intermittent?
Yeah, there's a thought. It's sticking, isn't it?
Yeah. It's happening in stop-start traffic, or it's happening...
Is it when it's really hot?
No, not really.
No? Intermittent.
Intermittent. Took Mrs. JC to work this morning. Okay.
Yeah.
Went and filled the cart with petrol. The light came on.
So it's not stinking hot, is it?
No, it's gone again. It's gone again now. I didn't have to turn the light on. It'd gone when I went to use the diagnostic machine. Bit strange, isn't it? Anyway, what did you reckon to the Kingbolen EDIAG Bluetooth?
You can have a diagnostic machine in your pocket at all times.
You can. I don't like the fact, however, that it's just seems a little bit overkill. But anyway.
No, but you've got, at any time you can go around diagnosing. You can walk up to people and say, excuse me, we've got your car diagnosed.
Excuse me, can I plug this machine into your car? Yeah, so long story short, more work coming on the Smart 451.
Did it give you some... I didn't see the screen. Did it give you sort of suggestions, like a... How do I put some
it just said P12.
Yeah, so it's but it went into the SAM.
Yeah.
Without asking it to.
No, it went into the whole thing. So it found more fault codes than before. Yeah. But we don't want to find more fault codes, really.
Yeah, but that indicator one was probably a stored fault.
It said they were stored, yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
Cool. Right, good. Well... Here's my roundup. I think it's a bit overkill. So the thing works. The diagnostic tool worked. I plugged it in okay and Bluetoothed it to my phone. I used a burner phone and a burner email address just in case. Am I right or wrong to be a bit dubious about that? Maybe. But it just adds an extra step, doesn't it? On the Kingbolen, it's wired in and it's I can just use it. I don't need to connect to my phone. I don't need to activate it. I don't need to download stuff. But it found faults the other one didn't. It found faults that other OBD readers hasn't found. Yeah. The link is in the description if you want to check it out from Kingbolen, the Ediag Elite. I suppose If you want to use it and have lots of functionality, give it a check out. It's diagnosed the fault on the smart, the P12. That's a separate issue for Dad and I to discuss, but yeah. Let me know in the comments down below. Am I going to rush out and buy one? No. Would I use it again? I prefer the other one they've sent me. It's just the extra steps and the having to have a phone and the having to download and having to have internet connection and having to do all this. I think we're overcomplicating OBD readers, in my opinion. And why has the EML light gone off again on the Smart 451? Yeah. It's a 6 out of 10 for me on that. Let me know. We'll speak to Dad. Tell him about the fault code and what we're going to do next. It's probably going to be replacing a variable valving solenoid. Great times. If you've enjoyed the video, thumbs up please. Comment down below. What do you reckon? Kingbolen, is that worth the money that it is on Amazon at the moment? I'm not telling you how much it is because the prices is going to go up and down. So click on the link in the description. I think this was about 50 quid when they sent me it. I'm here to be honest. Sorry, I'm not going to say it's the best thing in the world when I didn't find it intuitive and I didn't enjoy using it. Anyway, comment down below. What do you reckon to A, the smart car, EML, and B, the use of the Kingbolen? Have you got one? Have you tried one? Or do you think it's a load of time-wasting waffle? Yeah. And we'll have to do some more work on the Smart 451. Till next time, have a great day. Thanks for watching. See ya. As ever, thank you for watching this video. Dad and I have selected a couple more videos for you that we think that you might like. They're here now. Just give them a click to watch them. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. It means a lot to us. Thank you.